Science proceeds by two mechanisms that have to function together. One of them is reductionist, where we'll run an experiment that isolates something, and the other is synthesis, where we put things together that we've learned in all of these reductionist experiments and figure out what they imply. What happened in 1976 was Richard Dawkins wrote, or he published, The Selfish Gene. And The Selfish Gene is an excellent encapsulation of what it was at the time, the state-of-the-art understanding of the implication of genetics for adaptive evolution. And B, in chapter 11, he outlines the concept of mimetic evolution. Now, cultural evolution was understood a little bit. It was understood that it existed. But by codifying it in terms of memes, he opened the door to being able to understand human beings in rigorous evolutionary terms. Now, he made a giant error, which is not a big deal. We make errors. But he hasn't fixed it, which is, in chapter 11, he says that the cultural landscape is a new primeval soup. In other words, he posits that the cultural landscape is its own place for new kinds of creatures to evolve. And as you'll see tomorrow, that is not the most parsimonious way to understand cultural evolution. And once you understand what the relationship between the already existing genetic landscape and the cultural landscape is, you'll see it has tremendous implications for what human beings have been doing for the last several million years.